Morning Shamrocks and Stubbs. Today is Thursday, February 8th. Today we commemorate St. Jerome Emiliani. Please rise for the prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. O God, Father of mercies, who sent St. Jerome Emiliani as a helper and father to orphans, grant through his intercession that we may persevere faithfully in the spirit of adoption, by which we are called and truly are your children. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Morning, Shamrocks!
Welcome to your Green Day news for Thursday, February 8th.
I'm Ron Burgundy.
I'm Alex Burns, and here are today's announcements.
The For Green Society is celebrating Random Acts of Kindness Month.
Today's Random Act of Kindness is to consider attending the next Paragon Society meeting to support cancer awareness.
Shamrock Yoga Club. Shamrock Yoga Club with Miss Kristen will meet Mondays after school from 3 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. in the atrium. Join Miss Kristen and others to experience the benefit of yoga. Mats are provided, and there is no experience necessary. This opportunity is open to all students as well as faculty and staff.
Some of the benefits of yoga include stress relief, strength building, flexibility, mental focus, reduced anxiety, and injury recovery. See Ms. Crispin for more info or stop by the atrium on Monday, February 12th.
Resume writing workshop. Trayton College will be partnering with St. Patrick High School by offering a resume writing workshop. Learn how to properly present yourselves to respective employers with a professional resume. This is mandatory for seniors. The workshop will be from 8 to 9 a.m. on Wednesday, March 13th. See Mrs. Piper for more information.
The International Union of Operating Engineers, Local 150, is a labor union representing nearly 23,000 working men and women in Illinois, Indiana, and Iowa. The union represents workers in various industries, including construction, construction material development, public works, concrete pumping, steel mill service, slag processing, and more. Local 150 offers strong career opportunities. This field trip is open to anyone interested. The two dates to this field trip are February 2/23 or Monday 2/26.
There is limited space available, so please contact Ms. Piper by February 14th if you are interested at mpiper@stpatrick.org. Baseball season is quickly approaching, and Shamrock Baseball is hosting a fundraiser to prepare for the upcoming season. All are invited to support the team.
The date of the event is Saturday, February 17th at 6 p.m. at Emerald Isle.
Make sure you get to the game Friday against ND. If you do not go, Coach Luke will sit on you. Get to the game!
Aretha Franklin. Yeah, the one that sang.
R-E-F-E-C-T, find out what it means to me.
Yeah, that one. Aretha Louise Franklin was an American singer, songwriter, and pianist. Referred to as the Queen of Soul, Rolling Stones magazine named her as the greatest singer of all time twice. With global sales of over 75 million records, Franklin is one of the world's best-selling music artists. Some of her famous songs include Respect, Amazing Grace, and Rocksteady. She would unfortunately die in 2018 due to pancreatic cancer. However, the Queen of Soul will live on forever.
R-E-F-E-C-T, find out what it means to me. R-E-F-E-C-T.
Good morning, Shamrocks. This is going to be a different episode of the World News. Today, we will be going to talk to teachers about the cicada apocalypse happening in a few months.
Hi, everyone. This is Mrs. Burkholder here in the Science Department at St. Patrick High School. I teach biology, aquatic science, and our research. And I'm here to talk to you today about the cicada emergence. We have a double emergence coming out this year. It happens only every 221 years. So if we go back in history, that means Thomas Jefferson was president. We just got the Louisiana Purchase happening. And Lewis and Clark are in the middle, or I should say just starting, their exploration of the Western United States. So a few things have happened since then. But with this double emergence, that means not only the annual cicadas are coming out, the 13-year cicadas are coming out, and the 17-year cicadas are coming out. Cicadas do like to eat plants, so our trees and our shrubs are gonna get really hit hard by all of the cicadas that are coming out, plus the normal ones that usually eat everything in the spring. Which means it's gonna be kinda rough, it's gonna be loud, and a lot of the animals that eat insects are gonna have a great year for food, which means their young are gonna survive, which is wonderful.
My name is Mr. Krieger. I teach biology here at PATS. I was told to talk about the cicada apocalypse that's going to be happening here in the spring very shortly so we can prepare for it. You guys are going to be seeing a lot of cicadas because every 13 years or so, roughly, the cicada breeding cycle appears. So they come out of the ground and there are cicadas literally everywhere. However, instead, this year, instead of one species of cicadas coming up from the ground, there will be two. So they will literally be everywhere, lining trash cans, the sidewalk, outside, everywhere you go, there will be cicadas. So this doesn't happen very often, roughly every 13 or so years.
I was there during the last cicada apocalypse, and I was 17 years old. And so what's going to happen this year is that you're going to have cicadas that are not green. You're going to have some black and orange cicadas with red eyes, and they're going to be everywhere. But do not be alarmed, because they are harmless. They will not bite you. They may bump heads, or they may fly into you because their eyesight is horrible, but they are not going to harm you. Here's what happened when I was 17. They got in my house. They got in my chimneys, and they were all over outside of our garage and our trees and everything. I swear to you, look, it's crazy. They were freaking everywhere. And when I would go outside just to walk to my school bus, I would be met with hugs and headbutts of hundreds of cicadas at a time, sometimes on some days. But I think you guys will be fine. I think I'll be all right.
What's going on, guys? It's Wizix, aka Luke. We're back with another quote of the day. Today we're here with
Jason Richard.
All right, what's the quote of the day, Jason?
I never lose. Either I win or I learn.
Okay, I like that.
I'm gonna ask Vashawn, what's the quote of the day?
The quote of the day is your grand old school, because go St. Pat's.
Okay.
It's
Luke, and I'm gonna ask him, what's the quote of the day?
I'm gonna say stay hungry and never quit.
Okay, that's a good one. I'm a Mr. Herzog, and I'm asking him, what's the quote of the day?
Of course, it's early to bed, early to rise, makes a man healthy, wealthy, and wise.
Yeah. Okay.
We're here with...
Neil Vermeil.
What's the quote of the day?
The quote of the day is, when you're building up, always realize who's shooting you down.
saying?
I'm having trouble trying to sleep.
I'm counting sheep but running out.
As time ticks by, still I try.
No rest for crosstops in my mind.
On my own, here we go.
We are St. Pat's High School. We are waiting ready for these dons. We'll win state. St. Pat's will win state.
I'm here with
Ms. Reyes.
What class is this?
This is Principles of Visual Design.
What are you teaching right now?
Principles of Visual Design. It's just like general concepts.
All right, thank you. I'm here with
Special Ramirez.
What are you working on currently?
Drawing.
What's your favorite thing about this class?
Drawing.
Thank you.
It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there. Beyond the sky, it's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. I go to the movie and I go downtown. Somebody keep telling me don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother. Say, brother, help me, please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Lord, there have been times. But I know